Be Wealthy and Smart, episode 1020.
Into a world of wealth and financial freedom without budgets, boredom, or bosses on Be Wealthy and Smart. And now, here's your host, Linda P. Jones.
Welcome to Be Wealthy and Smart. I'm Linda P. Jones, America's Wealth Mentor, empowering women and men worldwide to financial freedom. On today's show, we're going to talk about why April is seasonally the second best month for stocks, but more importantly, why the narrative that is being talked about right now with the Fed tightening and getting more hawkish than they've been is just completely a red herring. Meaning, it's a lot of jawboning that's being speculated and talked about, but there's very little fact behind it. So we're going to talk about why the narrative is leading us away from what I believe is really the truth and what I've been saying on the podcast all along, which is a much more positive narrative than we're currently hearing. So first of all, there's a lot of jawboning about the Federal Reserve having to raise rates more quickly than we previously thought they were going to. And this is all based on minutes from the last Federal Reserve meeting. So there's a lot of speculation and fear because going into that last meeting, they were talking about how many interest rate hikes they may have to do. And then, of course, they made the decision to raise interest rates by 25 basis points or 0.25%. And so people are now looking at that meeting and the discussions saying, oh, the Fed is going to have to raise interest rates much faster now because inflation is so much worse, and on and on and on. I think that this jawboning has caused Treasury yields to be the highest that they've been in 3 years. So just people reporting on what the Fed has said has caused interest rates to rise. The Fed doesn't need to raise interest rates because the jawboning itself about the possibility of them raising interest rates does it for them. So I don't agree that the Fed has to be more aggressive. It's already happening, that interest rates are moving on their own. Now, I did find an article in the Business Insider that explained a little bit about what's going on with these minutes from the Fed meeting. And it says, minutes from the Fed's most recent policy meeting, at which it raised interest rates, showed officials were mostly in favor of a half-point rate hike last month, as well as rapid shrinking of the central bank's bloated balance sheet, both of which would tighten monetary policy more quickly. And investors took the view that the Fed will be a lot more aggressive than previously expected. Now, here's the thing about that. This is all about expectations and speculation. This is not the Fed actually coming out and saying these things in the current moment. It's my opinion that inflation will be allowed to run, and the Fed cannot afford to raise interest rates and cause a recession. And they know that. So I don't believe that they're going to raise interest rates as aggressively as the news continues to report. And we've been fighting this all year. From the beginning of the year, we came into it with all this news about rate hikes, et cetera, et cetera. And I predicted in my forecast for the year that we would have one rate hike in the first half of the year and one rate hike, possibly two, in the second half of the year. And I'm still sticking with that forecast. On top of that, we have April, which seasonally is the second best month of the year for stocks. So we're coming into a time where a lot of money gets invested in 401ks, a lot of people get their refunds back from taxes. April is a very strong month for new investment money to come in. Now, the outlier is what is going on with Russia and Ukraine. And of course, anything could happen there, which could impact oil prices, prices of gold, currency prices, etc. However, I do think that there are signs that by the end of May, we may see some big strides forward and maybe even peace talks with Russia and Ukraine. I continue to believe that this war that is going on between them is not going to go on for a long time. And I do think that there is going to be some sort of negotiation that is going to come from this. So let's see what happens in May. But I have thought that the market will go to new highs by late May and continue to go higher in the second and third quarter of this year, and that the surprises are on the upside, not on the downside, as so many of the professional hedge funds are short and are going to have to cover their shorts, and we have a massive rally coming on the upside. The massive crash is a crash that goes up where stocks have unlimited losses for these hedge funds on the upside. So as stock prices go up, that can bankrupt the hedge funds. So it's a reverse crash, if you will, where prices go higher. And that's what I've been seeing. So we'll see how that plays out as well. But in the meantime, people are overly bearish. The sentiment is sort of neutral right here to negative. I think we're going to see some more positive news come in. If we get lower oil prices, if we get peace in Russia, Ukraine, if we get better earnings, if we have any improvements in supply chains or in lower inflation, all of that's going to be unexpected good news for the market that can lead us higher. I do think most of the bad news is already priced in. So at this point, the surprise should be on the upside. So I'm staying positive. I think the bottom is in. We still have seen the worst behind us. Yes, we're going to go down and test the lows. We're going to have some pullbacks. We're going to have some scary days as we get some outlying news that's unexpected. But I am still positive that things are going to be better, and it's worth holding through and buying any dips that you see here. That's all for today. Until next time, live the good life and be wealthy and smart.
Thank you for listening to Be Wealthy and Smart with Linda P. Jones. Share the wealth and tell your family and friends about the show. Check out our website, blog, and social media for more riches at www.bewealthyandsmart.com.